Move aside, boys.
There's no time like the present.
Move aside.
There's no time like the present.
Move aside, boys. It's my turn.
That's my cue to play.
I'm ready to investigate. I'm prepared.
It's my time in the spotlight.
I heed the Lord's call.
I
It's my time.
I'm prepared.
I'm ready to investigate.
That's my cue to play.
Move aside.
There's no time like the present.
Move aside, boys. It's my turn.
That's my cue to play.
Move aside.
There's no time like a...
Move
aside.
It's my time in the spot.
I'm prepared.
There's no time like a present.
Move aside, boys.
That's my cue to play.
I'm ready to investigate.
I'm prepared.
I'm ready to
I'm prepared.
I'm ready to investigate.
Allow me to introduce myself. I am Wilhelmina Tillinghast, Professor of Astronomy at Miskatonic University. All my life I have dedicated myself to the study of celestial objects. Most recently I visited Louisiana to observe the passage of a comet I had observed for many years. The trip would provide me with the evidence required to conclude my decades-long research. Yesterday, you received my telegram requesting that you meet me at my house, just outside Arkham. And so, you've decided to join me in my mansion.
Professor Tillinghast's invitation to discuss her research intrigues me. Considering her long tenure at Miskatonic, she must have a great deal to teach me.
Welcome to my mansion, my friend.
I'd better ring the bell.
Maybe she's hard of hearing.
Oh, how rude of me to make you wait like this. I wonder whether something's wrong.
There's a light coming from that second floor window. She must be home. I hate to intrude, but I should see whether she needs help. Maybe there's another way in. It's no problem to reach the window, but it's shut tight. I'd need to smash the glass to get inside.
I hope you aren't thinking what I fear you're thinking.
What I need is something heavy to smash this window.
You smashed my window. I hope you intend to have it replaced.
I wouldn't have dared, but the professor did invite me. If she isn't answering the door, she must need help. A broken vase. The professor must have heard it fall. She wouldn't have just left it here.
I certainly would not. I take pride in a clean and tidy abode, especially when expecting visitors.
I'd better find her. That scream came from upstairs.
That sounds like my voice. I must need help.
Professor, was that you?
Of course it was. Hurry!
No answer. There must be someone else in the house. I ought to find a weapon. This knife might come in handy if I run into an intruder.
What on earth are you doing with my letter opener?
The scream came from this direction. I'd better take a look. The scream must have come from the other side of this door.
That's my office door.
Who's there?
I'll ask the questions. Roland Banks, Bureau of Investigation. I'm on the job. Who are you, and what's your reason for being here?
What would a federal agent want with me?
My name is Kate Winthrop, and I'm a colleague of Professor Tillinghast. She invited me here to discuss a research project, but when I heard her scream, I came to investigate.
Seems like I'm on the right track. Something hinky's going on here.
You can't seriously think a professor of her reputation is involved in some crime.
She's only a person of interest. The Bureau has evidence that others are trying to involve her in some shady business. I came to find out what she knows, if anything. Then I heard the scream, too. Seems we need a key to get inside that room.
I wasn't prepared for so many guests today.
I'll help you find that key.
There's a key on this mobile.
My files say Tillinghast has no children. If that's true, why would she need a nursery?
The professor always wished for children, even long after she grew too old to have them.
Oh, I can't say it isn't true, but I wish people were less prone to idle gossip. An intruder! How many people can I expect to break into my house today?
Who are you?
Listen, pal. You've got some explaining to do. Come then.
I have just the explanation you deserve.
What's going on?
We'd better have a look inside.
Are you?
What happened here? Is that...
Wait. That's me. That is... It's my... body.
That's Professor Tillinghast, all right. She won't be telling me much anymore.
We need to stop them. Who were those cloaked figures? This wasn't just a burglary.
You're right about that. It must be connected to my investigation. We better have a look around.
What's this weird symbol drawn on the floor? Is that blood?
My nice, clean floor. Ruined.
That looks like some kind of cult symbol. This ain't a garden variety burglary.
Oh, dear heavens! Who would commit such an atrocity on a kindly academic?
Despite my age, I had much more to do in life.
This wound on her stomach? It looks like she was knifed. Look at these notebooks. Is this the professor's handwriting?
It is, but how would you know?
There's no useful information here, but perhaps Professor Tillingist kept notes on this material in another location. What's this mess?
Yeah, a broken jar or flask. Can make out a few letters. Miska, Uni, Lab.
Obviously, this was a flask from the Miskatonic University Science Lab.
We've found everything we're liable to find here. Time to see where the evidence leads us.
And so, my friend set out to discover how I was killed. Of my office makes it clear you must visit Miskatonic University. Not only did I work there, but the broken jar came from the university lab. Why did those strange men need it? Whatever the answer, you're sure to find it at Miskatonic. Welcome to Miskatonic University, home of the prestigious Orne Library, which includes the country's largest collection of occult books. I once studied here as a student, later donning the mantle of professor and passing along all I learned to the next generation of astronomy students. This place was like a second home to me. Perhaps the things I left behind will provide you with clues to the answers you seek.
Ah, science and astrophysics. I'll feel right at home here.
No, it has changed over the years. But no place feels more like home to me. Not even my little house.
The secretary said Professor Norman Withers could give us access to Professor Tillinger's office. But what do we expect to find?
We won't know until we look.
All right, let's brace this Withers character and find out what's what.
With offices right next to each other, Professors Tillinghast and Withers were bound to have been friends, or rivals.
Professor Tillinghast's door is locked.
But of course, my friend. Academics are no less prone to snooping around each other's secrets. Some have even been known to steal a colleague's research and present it as their own.
We'd better ask Withers for the key.
I say no, Agatha. You will pardon me for saying I have never believed your methods to be the least bit scientific. I refuse to believe that Wilhelmina would have...
Oh, they're talking about me. Norman and I were colleagues for years. So naturally, we addressed each other by our Christian names. You, of course, may call me Professor Tillinghast.
Yes, what is it? How can I help you?
Pardon the intrusion, Professor Withers. We're investigating Professor Tillinghast's unfortunate death, and we...
Not again. Can't an old man mourn his friend in peace? Oh, these constant intrusions by reporters and police and garden variety busybodies. As I told your friends earlier, I do not wish to be disturbed.
Listen, pal.
Wait just a moment, Norman. Something tells me these people aren't the same as the others. Look at their eyes. They've seen things beyond the quotidian. Oh, forgive my manners. I'm Professor Agatha Crane, and you seem to know of my colleague, Professor Norman Withers. Something tells me you've seen Wilhelmina, haven't you? That is, Professor Tillinghast.
Agatha, for heaven's sake, stop this nonsense!
No, Professor Withers. She's right. We have seen unusual things. We arrived too late to save Professor Tillinghast, but we've seen evidence that whatever happened to her was unnatural, to say the least. We intend to get to the bottom of it.
I told you, Norman, that box could hold more than knickknacks and jewjaws. I, for one, want to see it for myself. You there, come with me.
What? Where are you going, you confounded parapsychologist?
To the observatory. Wait here, Norman. I know you won't want to be disturbed further.
Old observatory. Don't be fooled by its antiquated fixtures, my friends. Of course, the new Gerald Warren Astronomical Observatory is a technological marvel, but I shall always remember this one more fondly. Through these telescopes, I first gazed with wonder at the stars and the vast voids between them.
Could it be? Yes, these glyphs indicate gestures of power, of magic. This, my friends, is a grimoire, a book of spells. What it is doing at the university, I cannot say, but we mustn't let this opportunity go to waste. We must see whether these spells work. Here is the mysterious box.
The label marks it as belonging to Professor Tillinghast. What are the...
This symbol. It was in Professor Tillinghast's room.
You've seen this symbol in Wilhelmina's room, haven't you? It is similar to the iconography of ancient pagan rituals. Here is proof that Wilhelmina's research went beyond known science and into the realm of the paranormal.
Many of our colleagues questioned Agatha's unorthodox avenues of research, but none questioned her resolve. Once she sets her mind to a goal, nothing can stop her.
We must show this to Norman. Only then will he help us. Look here, Norman. See the odd things in this box of Wilhelmina's? Whatever she was researching, it was far more than that comet.
I don't see what this has to do with her death.
We saw a sign identical to the one on this box in the room where Professor Tillinghast was killed.
I must admit that seems far too unlikely to be mere coincidence. Very well. You have my attention and my help. Wilhelmina left Arkham earlier this year, and I received this box. After hearing no word from her, I became concerned, and I confess, I briefly searched her office for some indication of the purpose of her travel.
Oh, Norman, you dear fool. I was only gone a week. Why did you worry so?
Unfortunately, I couldn't make sense of her notes. They made no sense to me. I did sense a whiff of the occult about them, which I admit made me uneasy.
We academics must stick together, don't you agree, Professor? Let's share our knowledge to get to the truth.
You're right, of course. Yeah, take the key to Wilhelmina's office. While you have a look in there, I'll pore over these notes again.
What was that sound? It came from next door.
My office? Who's in there?
What was that commotion? There's nobody here.
Someone beat us to it. The room's been searched, and recently.
Just look at this mess. Someone has ransacked my office.
Look there. Even the safe is broken open.
Now they're on the lam. We gotta nab them before they get off campus.
Whoever it is must be dangerous. You must protect the students.
Judging by their clothes, these are the same people who were in the professor's house.
They're the ones who looted her office. Stop them!
Who are these interlopers? Deal with them while the others escape!
That scream is coming from down the corridor.
Oh no, the students!
Must be one of those weird burglars. Let's go!
That scream came from right around here.
This was Wilhelmina's classroom. It sounds as though some students have locked themselves in.
Who? Who's out there?
It's me, Professor Crane. Are you all right in there?
We're safe, but some strange people attacked us. We managed to barricade ourselves inside.
You stay put until we've dealt with them. Did you see which way they were heading?
They ran down the next corridor. Be careful, Professor. They look dangerous.
After we handle those burglars, we should come back here. If this was Professor Tillinghast's classroom, we might find clues inside.
Come here, you!
Help me!
We must protect the students.
Help me! Are you all right? Thank you. I think I'll be fine. It's mostly shock.
This was just a diversion. We need to catch up to the men that were in Professor Tillinghast's office. Are you hurt?
No, just bruised. Some men in weird costumes knocked me down.
Which way did they go?
They ran right into that classroom.
There they are. They have the professor's things. Get them back.
These fools mustn't stop us. Deal with them.
Thank you.
they won't be knocking down any more students. Now let's see what they took from Professor Tillinghast's office.
Robbing the robbers? It would all seem a bit tawdry if it weren't so poetic.
This letter indicates that Professor Tillinghast reserved the science lab for some experiment. Maybe it doesn't solve the mystery. But now we have a couple more names to go on. Alphonse Lanowit and the Herd.
I don't recognize those names.
Alphonse Lanowit, an unsavory character indeed.
These clues might not make sense now, but we might be able to connect them to others later.
I think that's all they took.
We should return to Wilhelmina's classroom and tell the students the way is clear.
If that's the case, let's check the classroom. If it was Professor Tillinghast, we're bound to find some clue about what happened to her.
Thank you.
It's all clear, students. We've taken care of those brutes.
Thank you, Professor.
Let's make sure everyone is unhurt. Then, let's have a look around this classroom.
Professor Tillinghast's body vanished from the cemetery? How ghastly!
Who on earth would steal my corpse? It must have been grave robbers, of course. It isn't as though I could have leapt up and walked away.
This Albert Hatcher is our only witness. We should visit him when we're done here.
Thank you.
Here it is again, the Herd of Algidi. There's some sort of astronomy club. That explains the professor's interest.
They're based in New Orleans.
Perhaps that's where the professor went on her trip.
That makes sense, since she circled the name in the book.
I do feel a pang of guilt at defacing a book in such a manner. I must have had a very good reason for it.
We could have been more methodical in our research, but I think we've completed an examination of all the professor's likely locations.
It's about time we return to Norman's office. Perhaps he's made some headway with those notes.
Oh, you're back at last. Did you find the cause of the commotion?
We took care of it, Doc. Still, there might be trouble ahead.
At least we discovered more about what happened to the professor. Although we also encountered a new problem.
An enemy of Wilhelmina, poppycock. Everyone liked her, even the students.
Do you know any reason why she requested exclusive access to the science lab for several days?
What? No, she had no need of a lab. As an astronomer, she spent most of her time in the observatory, not among flasks and beakers.
The broken glass we found in Professor Tillinghast's house looked like it might have been a flask or beaker.
Here, this is the key to the science lab. You can find the entrance in front of Wilhelmina's classroom. How did you? I could have sworn I locked that door. You'll regret opening it.
There's something very wrong about that man.
Look what he did to that god! Grab him before he tries it with us!
Thank you.
What just happened?
That man cast a spell. Oh, I know how that sounds, but you saw it with your own eyes. Something Wilhelmina researched proved dangerous, fatally so for her.
What is this thing? Is it even alive? I've never seen anything like it.
No matter its origin, you must admit it is a scientifically important discovery.
That container looks the same as the broken glass we found at Professor Tillinger's house. Do you suppose someone took one there? We can't let this thing fall into the wrong hands. We better take it with us.
A thorough study of the cadaver might reveal fascinating data.
Are you sure that's such a good idea?
We should at least examine the thing. Who knows what clues its body might hold?
I suppose it might tell us something about what happened to Professor Tillinghast.
Yes, that seems like the prudent decision. Gravekeeper Albert Hatcher is the only one who saw how my body left the cemetery. And whatever it was broke his sanity. Questioning a madman might not be easy, but it's the only lead you have.